I gotta join up my country, boy.
I did the best I could do.
Here's what we got left of it.
The best I could tell.
Smells delicious.
The higher I flew, the farther I fell.
That's what we smoking on tonight. I put a picture on as a thumbnail so you get a better look at it. Hopefully you guys are having a good night. Let's spark this baby up and let's catch a buzz. I had a piece of my banana nut bread about an hour and a half ago. It's got a delicious taste to it. Got a like a kind of a fruity, real fruity taste to it, but kind of skunky. It's fruity on the beginning and a little bit of skunky on the end, if that makes any sense to you.
That's where I wanna be. A little out of time.
Hopefully you guys can hear me. Oh man, this shit just tastes so delicious. You know, taste. I gotta give it about an 8. It's got a really good taste to it. You know how when you wake up in the morning and you perk your first pot of coffee and the smell and the smell of it just starts tingling your senses? Well, when I start rolling up a joint of this, that's what happens. I'm sorry I didn't bring you guys a harvest video, but I was making you one. And in the meantime of making it, my phone went dead and I lost 3 hours of trimming, so. Needless to say, it didn't save. But I got another one here probably in 2 more weeks. We got the other country boy. We're probably gonna have to harvest in about 2 weeks. I fed it its last feeding Sunday of nutrients, and from now on, for the next 2 weeks, it'll just get straight water. And I've got most of my plants switched over to cocoa core. This run, I'm gonna use cocoa core, and I'm gonna let you guys know what I think. I've used soil my whole life. This run, I'm gonna use cocoa core, and we'll see what the difference is. Hopefully you guys are smoking on something delicious. Or munching on something delicious. Man, I tell you guys what, I made some double dose banana cinnamon bread. And it was delicious, and this shit has just been fucking me up all day. And I make it from scratch. I don't cheat no way on it. My banana nut bread, it's made all from scratch. If you want nuts in it, you put nuts. If you don't, you don't. I don't like the nuts, so what I do is I substitute a cup of chocolate chips and a cup of peanut butter chips. I'm sorry, sorry, sorry. A half a cup of each, chocolate chips and peanut butter chips. I used a Hershey Specially Dark. Oh my God, talking about delicious banana nut bread. Cheers. Now, as far as looks goes, it's all crystally and looks like it's been snowed on. But I could have done a better job trimming. I just didn't want to cut off all the pretty little sugar-coated leaves. I mean, I'm smoking it myself, so it don't matter to me. I trimmed it till I thought it looked pretty, and then I quit. And I tell you guys what, this shit's got a hell of a buzz to it too. Fucking don't think you're gonna smoke this and play video games, cause it ain't gonna happen. You're gonna be sitting here playing a video game, and next thing you know, you're gonna be down for the count. Man, that's good. What you into, Scuba Steve? How you been, brother? Thanks for stopping by. We smoking on some homegrown. So remember to have, I don't know if you've watched too many of my videos or not, but this is the plant that we was growing. Oh man, and it was well worth the wait. I've smoked about all of it. Right there is what's left. I love it. You know, that's the thing a lot of people don't understand. If you grow your own medicine, when you smoke it, you just feel like you accomplished so much. This run coming up, we've got Girl Scout cookies. We got Tahoe G, courtesy of Bazego Innovations. We got, I've been doing pretty good. Been busy, you know, we've been trying to find a house. Well, we found us a house and we got the lease signed on it and everything. So we're trying to get everything ready to move. I'm so glad to be out. You'd be getting out of this apartment. And, man, it's just like a big weight lifted off my shoulders. I mean, the house, it's an older house. It needs a little bit of work, but hell, I can do all the work myself. Cheers, Scuba. I just been taking a little bit of time away from YouTube, you know. Been stressed out. You know, been had like a, you know what writer's block is? Well, I've had writer's block just towards my videos. And hello, Big Ed. You know, I've been doing a lot of baking. Been having fun. I ain't I ain't been baking, you know, too much shit for nobody but myself. I've been baking a lot of brownies. I've been playing with this Periwinkle's cookbook, and I've made a few tweaks. And I've got it to where I'm happy with my results. I'm already stoned. Got a new piece of glass, guys. I just don't like the way it sits. It's kind of wobbly. It's a little bubbler. I like it. But I still like my joints. I'd rather smoke a joint than any bowl. Especially if you put hash in your joint, coat it with all that rosin, and then fucking put some keef on it, then that's when you got a really good, tasty joint. I've been working on my hash making a little bit. Been having fun making some hash. It's been a learning adventure, but I think I pretty well got down the method I like. Can you guys hear that? Then this one, I tried a method on YouTube that I seen where they put water on it and they heat it and all that. And it didn't come out as smooth as what I wanted, but it smokes pretty good. Then I tried the Frenchy cannoli method, you know, where you take to fill your bottle of hot water, then you roll it out and all that. It turned out all right. But I like the method I used to make these little balls. Hell of a lot more simpler. I don't know if my eyes are red or not, but damn, they sure feel red. Wow. I don't think I should have ate that other edible. I had one this morning, and I smoked the joint. Oh shit, I done dropped my joint. And that lasted me up to 5 o'clock. And then here a little bit ago, I had another edible. Now we smoking us another joint. Tell you guys what, if you've ever had problems making edibles, get you a Periwinkle's cookbook and his crock pot method for infusing the oil. Oh my God, it's so simple. Anybody could do it. Except I don't know if it's just I got a high tolerance or not, but he says put 1 ounce of bud per 6 cups of coconut oil. I put 1 ounce of bud for every cup. I mean, I want medicine. I don't want to have to eat 4 or 5 brownies, you know? I'm big enough as it is. I want to eat one brownie, smoke a joint, and be good for 4 or 5 hours. And I'm happy I'm at that. Now, I made some double-dose banana nut bread. Oh, my God. It is delicious. And that shit will put you down. I've been tired all day. I've been yawning my ass off. the last batch of edibles I made out of straight sativa, and I couldn't sleep on them. Cheers, everybody out there. I wish y'all was here to taste this. This is just deliciousness. I gotta actually say, I've enjoyed burning this joint. I mean, I've enjoyed smoking the whole damn plant. But the bad thing is, I was a dumbass and I cut down. I had 3 mils. I should have wished I'd have kept one of them. Because now my strain's dead, and I'll probably never get these genetics again. But I'm gonna clone my the one I've got growing right now. Same plant, same seeds. We'll try the aloe vera cloning method this time. You know, I make these little hash balls, and I usually make them between a gram and a half. And the reason I make them is that way I can just drop the whole ball down in a pipe and just smoke the whole fucking thing. I save them for nights when I can't sleep. Yeah, I think I could have done a little bit better job on the flush. We ain't got black ash, but we ain't got total white ash either. I see a few little specks of black in there. But it don't taste bad. It tastes clean. I just think I could have went a couple more days in the flush. But it burns good. It don't go out. It don't taste bad. It don't burn your lungs. It's mostly white ash. It's just got a little bit of black specks in it, every little bit, you know. Damn, I'm fried, y'all. I just wanted to jump on here. I miss y'all. I just wanted to jump on here and smoke a doobie with y'all. Because, I mean, you guys have been here with me throughout this whole grow. And it'd be a shame to smoke it all without sharing some of it with y'all. I'm fried, y'all. I'm sorry, but I just can't help it. I just feel like smiling. That's a roach. Man, I am fried. Hopefully you guys are as fried as I am, or at least half as fried as I am. My whole body's tingling. I feel like I could run a marathon. Man, I can't wait to smoke the hash off this. I got about 2 pounds of trim. And I'll have more after I harvest this other one, you know, of the sugar leaf. I'm gonna make some fucking water hash. Some bubble hash. Hell, let's smoke this a little bit of this hash. Should be good. And this hash is Afghani and chocolate Thai mixed. So it's a little bit indica and a little bit sativa. Cheers. That is delicious. I bought this little pipe specifically just for a hash pipe. That's all I smoke in this one's hash. And I just bought it the other day and I got a really good deal on it. Fucking, I got this for $15. Can't beat it. It's heavy too. Cheers. Amazing what they have come up with. I'd have loved to have something like this when I first started smoking pot. When I first started smoking pot, we were smoking out of pop cans. Then we graduated from pop cans to aluminum foil in a 20-ounce bottle. Then it went from a 20-ounce bottle to a 2-liter bottle. Hell. You guys know them fish tanks? They're like, they was like 4 inches around. And they had the fake fish in them that floated around. The bubbler moved the fish around. I made a water bong out of one of them and some PVC pipe. Put a socket, like a metal socket down inside the PVC pipe, and then put your screen inside the socket so it don't get the plastic hot. Talking about a monster. If you cleared it, you was fucked up off one hit. Cheers. Excuse me, I gotta get a bottle of water. Now that is what I would definitely, what I would call a full body hash. On your exhale, it is just very perfumey. Is the best way that I can describe it. It's like a real perfumey taste. Of course, that's the taste I look for in a good quality hash. You know, it don't go out, it stays burning. Cheers. That was hot. And we put probably a half a gram hash in here. It was a gram and a half, so I'd say there's probably a gram still there. overall, I am stoned, y'all. I'm sitting here feeling like shock waves going through my body. We've done a double dose banana nut bread. It's about 800 milligrams to 800 to 1,000 milligrams, somewhere in that area. I did a gram joint of my country boy, and now we're smoking this hash. So I'm feeling pretty damn good. But see, I waited an hour and a half before I started smoking. I hope you guys are as high as I am. Cheers. It's hot. I wish that'd go out. Damn it, it's hot. Fuck it, let it burn. It ain't going nowhere. It ain't gonna hurt my feelings none. I done got burnt. But I've been getting caught up on my edibles, y'all. Mastering the art of baking with cannabis. And I've been having a lot of fun playing with a vacuum sealer. Look at all them edibles. My whole freezer's full. Here's some country boy that I froze on the stem. I've been vacuum sealing everything. I never know that vacuum sealing could be addictive. My God, if it ain't. I've vacuum sealed everything in my house. And I found out things that you can't vacuum seal. Perhaps you can't vacuum seal liquid inside a bag. I bought a bottle of rum to make, but brandy to make brownies with. I wasn't going to drink it, so I was going to vacuum seal it. And it didn't work. Once the bottle of liquor's open, you can't vacuum seal it. But guys, my phone's going to go dead. So I'm going to have to end this. Cheers, and hopefully you guys have a wonderful night. Thanks for stopping by. Once I get moved, I'm going to be putting out more content, you know. It's been hectic. Peace. Growers love, and you all have a good night. Cheers.